The people who are working these shows are also the tech crew at the venue or things like that, and they want to learn these new things. They want to see this new technology that there is that they don't usually get to play with. So yeah, we budget in time for things like that where, you know, we invite them back when we're all plugged in and ready to go so they can see the hard work that they've done. I like to maintain a really close proximity between the crowd and the DJ. You never want them to feel disconnected. You really can't get a feel for what they're doing up there if all you can see is their, you know, their head behind a laptop. So that's why our mix and our stage is done this way. It's really powerful to see their feet, which is something you never see.
We've got that drummer, that DJ opening for us, Scottish duo. The school booked them to open for us.
So what we've done is we've separated them, flanking either side of our main stage.
Which I think is great for the students who are coming to the show because they're going to get two shows. And I've been talking to their student activities board and they say they haven't had events in 3 years. And we're bringing back
something like this.
Which is absurd. Yes. Yeah,
from zero to visceral.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, the whole goal is to show that separation. We're not a club where you go there and it's the one DJ booth and the music starts pounding right from the beginning. We're trying to treat it like a show. So there's different phases to it. When you first come in, there's no DJ. And then you know that the party hasn't even begun yet because, well, obviously that stage is there for a reason. So to separate someone like that, it gives the impression that this isn't it. We don't want people to think that this is it because we really throttle it back until we're ready. So when they walk in, we haven't turned everything on that we have here.